Hello, welcome back to another episode in the Swafinia series. This is a follow-up episode to the previous video, the comprehensive list of flora left in Swafinia. In today's comprehensive list episode, we'll see the comprehensive list of the fauna left on Swafinia, both terrestrial and marine ones, since you can't have a stable ecosystem with just swamphens. We'll begin with sponges and corals, then the echinoderms, then move on to the vertebrates and finish it off with the rest of the invertebrates. Also, Pia has a new voice now.
Hello, I have a new voice.
Anyways, let's get into it, shall we?
It's fair to say that things like large protozoans and other miscellaneous microscopic animals like hydra have already been seeded. Like I said, we'll begin in a specific order, so without further ado, let's get into it.
Corals are marine invertebrates within the class Amphizoa of the phylum Cnidaria. They typically form compact colonies of many identical individual polyps. Coral species include the important reef builders that inhabit tropical oceans and secrete calcium carbonate to form a hard skeleton. A coral group is a colony of very many genetically identical polyps. Each polyp is a sac-like animal, typically only a few millimeters in diameter and a few centimeters in height. A set of tentacles surround a central mouth opening. Each polyp excretes an exoskeleton near the base. Over many generations, the colony thus creates a skeleton characteristic of the species which can measure up to several meters in size. Individual colonies grow by asexual reproduction of polyps. Corals also breed sexually by spawning. Polyps of the same species release gametes simultaneously overnight, often around a full moon. Fertilized eggs form planulae, a mobile early form of the coral polyp which, when mature, settles to form a new colony, although some corals are able to catch plankton and small fish using stinging cells on their tentacles. Most corals obtain the majority of their energy and nutrients from photosynthetic unicellular dinoflagellates of the genus Symbiodinium that live within their tissues. These are commonly known as zooxanthellae and give the coral color. Such corals require sunlight and grow in clear, shallow water, typically at depths less than 60 meters. Sponges, the members of the phylum Porifera, are a basal animal clade as a sister of the diplobolists. They are multicellular organisms that have bodies full of pores and channels allowing water to circulate through them, consisting of jelly-like mesohyll sandwiched between two thin layers of cells. Sponges have unspecialized cells that can transform into other types and that often migrate between the main cell layers and the mesohyll in the process. Sponges do not have nervous, digestive or circulatory systems. Instead, most rely on maintaining a constant water flow through their bodies to obtain food and oxygen and to remove wastes. Sponges were first to branch off the evolutionary tree from the last common ancestor of all animals, making them the sister group of all other animals. The red sea urchin Mesocentridis franciscanus is a sea urchin found in the northeastern Pacific Ocean from Alaska to Baja California. It lives in shallow waters from the low tide line to greater than 280 meters, 920 feet deep, and is typically found on rocky shores sheltered from extreme wave action in areas where kelp is available. A sea urchin's spherical body is completely covered by sharp spines. These spines grow on a hard shell called the test, which encloses the animal. It can vary in color from red to dark burgundy. It has a mouth located on its underside, which is surrounded by five teeth. During larval development, the body of a sea urchin transitions from bilateral to radial symmetry. This bilaterally symmetrical larva, called an Echinopluteus, subsequently develops a type of pentaradiate symmetry that characterizes echinoderms. It crawls very slowly over the sea bottom using its spines as stilts, with the help of its tube feet. Scattered among its spines are rows of tiny tube feet with suckers that help it to move and stick to the sea floor. This animal has a mouth with special jaws, Aristotle's lantern, located on the bottom, oral, surface. Its preferred diet is seaweeds and algae, which it scrapes off and tears up from the seafloor. During larval development, urchins use bands of cilia to capture food from the water column. Red sea urchins found in the channel adjacent to San Juan Island have been found to live a uniquely sedentary lifestyle with the heavy currents bringing an abundance of food.
Protorester nodosus, commonly known as the horned sea star or chocolate chip sea star, is a species of sea star found in the warm, shallow waters of the Western Pacific Ocean. They are sometimes seen in marine aquarium trade, or dried and sold as curios. P. nodosus possesses rows of spines or horns, black conical points arranged in a single row radially on the dorsal side, which may erode and become blunt. These dark protrusions are used to scare away possible predators by looking frightening or dangerous. On the ventral side, tube feet, purple in color or pale transparent pink, are arranged in rows on each arm. Most horned sea stars found are a roughly rigid five-pointed star shape with tapering arms to the end, although there are anomalies like four or six armed specimens. They may grow up to 30 centimeters in diameter. The sea stars are usually colored in shades of red or brown, but can be a light tan, the color of cookie dough. This appearance, combined with the small horns on its dorsal side, give the sea star a look similar to that of a bumpy cookie. Horned sea stars prefer sheltered, sandy, or slightly muddy bottoms to hard substrata such as coral reefs, and are frequently sighted conspicuously between the leaves of seagrasses on seagrass meadows or on a blank stretch of coral sand. In shallow water, these species can be seen intertidally, occasionally exposed to the low tide. They do not withstand rapid changes well, however, and usually keep themselves underwater. Horned sea stars seem to be opportunistic carnivores. Adults are known to prey on most sessile life forms, including hearts, corals, and sponges in aquarium. In this same setting, they will hunt down snails and eat them. An individual of horned sea star has also been observed eating a sea urchin in their natural habitat. The Australasian swamphen, Porphyria melanotis, is a species of swamphen occurring in eastern Indonesia, the Moluccas, Aru and Kai Islands, Papua New Guinea, Australia, and New Zealand. In New Zealand, it is known as the pukekos. The species used to be considered a subspecies of purple swamphen. The New Zealand population, along with the green-yellow swamphens in Tasmania, are possibly slightly larger than the mainland Australian birds, but are otherwise identical. When threatened, they will often walk away from danger rather than fly. When they fly, takeoffs and landings are clumsy and short flight distances are preferred. They're mostly vegetarian, but also eat invertebrates, eggs, frogs, small fish, chicks and mammals, especially in breeding season where the chicks are fed protein-rich animals. Pukekos are cooperative breeders, with multiple male and female birds often sharing a nest and responsibility for incubating eggs and raising chicks. They live in groups of 3 to 12 individuals and are known to group together and shriek loudly to defend their nests successfully during attacks by Australasian harriers. Where unsuccessful at repelling predators, they may abandon their nest sites. A recent arrival to New Zealand, they have thrived in an environment that now contains introduced predators such as cats, rodents, and mustelids. The axolotl, Ambystoma mexicanum, is a patamorphic salamander closely related to the tiger salamander. Axolotls are unusual among amphibians in that they reach adulthood without undergoing metamorphosis. Instead of taking to the land, adults remain aquatic and gilled. The species was originally found in several lakes underlying what is now Mexico City, such as Lake Xochimilco and Lake Chalco. Essentially mature adult axolotl, at age 18 to 27 months, ranges in length from 15 to 45 centimeters, although a size close to 23 centimeters is most common and greater than 30 centimeters is rare. Axolotls possess features typical of salamander larvae, including external gills and a caudal fin extending from behind the head to the vent. External gills are usually lost when the salamander species mature into adulthood, although the axolotl maintains this feature. This is due to their neoteny evolution, where axolotls are much more aquatic than other salamander species. Their heads are wide and their eyes are lidless. Their limbs are underdeveloped and possess long, thin digits. Males are identified by their swollen cloacae lined with papillae,
while females are noticeable for their wider bodies full of eggs. Axolotls have barely visible vestigial teeth, which develop during metamorphosis. The primary method of feeding is by suction, during which their rakers interlock close to the gill slits.
The common frog or grass frog Rana temporaria is a semi-aquatic amphibian of the family Ranidae, found throughout much of Europe as far north as Scandinavia and as far east as the Urals, except for most of Iberia, southern Italy, and the southern Balkans. The farthest west it can be found is Ireland. It is also found in Asia, and eastward to Japan. The nominative, and most common, subspecies Rana temporaria is a largely terrestrial frog native to Europe. It is distributed throughout northern Europe and can be found in Ireland, the Isle of Lewis, and as far east as Japan. Common frogs metamorphose through three distinct developmental life stages: aquatic larva, terrestrial juvenile, and adult. They have corpulent bodies with a rounded snout, webbed feet, and long hind legs adapted for swimming in water and hopping on land. The channel catfish Ictalaris punctatus is North America's most numerous catfish species. It is the official fish of Kansas, Missouri, Iowa, Nebraska, and Tennessee, and is informally referred to as a channel cat. Channel catfish are native to the Nearctic, being well distributed in lower Canada and the eastern and northern United States, as well as parts of northern Mexico. They have also been introduced into some waters of landlocked Europe, Czech Republic and Romania, and parts of Malaysia and almost as many parts of Indonesia. They thrive in small and large rivers, reservoirs, natural lakes, and ponds. Channel cats are cavity nesters, meaning they lay their eggs in crevices, hollows, or debris, to protect them from swift currents. In Canada, the species is largely, though not exclusively, limited to the Great Lakes watershed. From Lake Nipigon southward, channel catfish possess very keen senses of smell and taste. At the pits of their nostrils, nares, are very sensitive odor-sensing organs with a very high concentration of olfactory receptors. In channel catfish, these organs are sensitive enough to detect several amino acids at about 1 part per 100 million inches water. In addition, the channel catfish has taste buds distributed over the surface of its entire body. These buds are especially concentrated on the fish's 4 pair of barbels whiskers surrounding the mouth, about 25 buds per square millimeter. This combination of exceptional senses of taste and smell allows the channel catfish to find food in dark, stained, or muddy water with relative ease. They also possess a Weberian apparatus, which amplifies sound waves that would otherwise not be perceivable. Plotosus linnaeus, common name striped eel catfish, is a species of eel-tail catfishes belonging to the family Plotosidae. Plotosus linnaeus can reach a maximum length of 32 centimeters, 13 in. The body is brown with cream-colored or white longitudinal bands. The most striking feature of this species is in the fins. In fact, the second dorsal, caudal and anal are fused together as an eel's. In the rest of the body is quite similar to a freshwater catfish. The mouth is surrounded by 4 pairs of barbels, 4 on the upper jaw and 4 on the lower jaw. The first dorsal and each of the pectoral fins have a highly venomous spine. They may even be fatal. Juveniles of Plotosus linnaeus form dense ball-shaped schools of about 100 fish, while adults are solitary or occur in smaller groups of around 20 and are known to hide under ledges during the day. Adult P. linnaeus search and stir the sand incessantly for crustaceans, mollusks, worms, and sometimes fish. P. linnaeus is an oviparous fish. This species has demersal eggs and planktonic larvae. It has evolved long ampullary canals in its electrosensory organs. The European pilchard, Sardina pilchardus, is a species of ray-finned fish in the monotypic genus Sardina. The young of the species are among the many fish that are sometimes called sardines. This common species is found in the Northeast Atlantic, the Mediterranean, and the Black Sea at depths of 10-100 meters, 33 to 328 feet. It reaches up to 27.5 centimeters, 10.8 in, length and mostly feeds on planktonic crustaceans. This schooling species is a batch spawner where each female lays 50,000 to 60,000 eggs. The European pilchard is a small to medium-sized, somewhat elongated, herring-like fish. The origin of the pelvic fins is well behind that of the dorsal fin, and the last two soft rays on the anal fin are larger than the remainder. The upper parts are green or olive, the flanks are golden and the belly is silvery. The European pilchard occurs in the northeastern Atlantic Ocean, the Mediterranean Sea, and the Black Sea. Its range extends from Iceland and the southern part of Norway and Sweden southwards to Senegal in West Africa. In the Mediterranean Sea, it is common in the Western Half and the Adriatic Sea, but uncommon in the Eastern Half and the Black Sea. It is a migratory, schooling, largely coastal species, but sometimes travels as far as 100 kilometers 62 mi out to sea. During the day, it is mostly in the depth range 25 to 55 meters, 80 to 180 feet, but can go as deep as 100 meters, 330 feet. At night, it is generally from 10 to 35 meters, 33 to 115 feet beneath the surface.
The Atlantic tarpon, Megalops atlanticus, is a ray-finned fish that inhabits coastal waters, estuaries, lagoons, and rivers. It is also known as the Silver King. It is found in the Atlantic Ocean, typically in tropical and subtropical regions, though it has been reported as far north as Nova Scotia and the Atlantic coast of southern France, and as far south as Argentina. As with all elapiforms, it spawns at sea. Its diet includes small fish and crustaceans. Atlantic tarpon evolved approximately 18 million years ago and are one of the oldest living fish. It has been recorded at 2.5 meters in length and weighing up to 161 kilograms. Males rarely weigh more than 45 kilograms though. A tarpon is capable of filling its swim bladder with air, like a primitive lung. This gives it a predatory advantage where oxygen levels in the water are low. In appearance, it is greenish or bluish on the top and silver on the sides. The large mouth is turned upwards and the lower jaw contains an elongated bony plate. The last ray of the dorsal fin is much longer than the others, reaching nearly up to the tail. The diet of the Atlantic tarpon changes as the fish grows, with those in the leptocephalous stages absorbing nutrients directly from the water, those in the juvenile stage eating zooplankton and other small prey, and adults primarily consuming fish, crabs, and shrimp.
The chub mackerel, Pacific mackerel, or Pacific chub mackerel Scombra japonicus, is a species of fish in the tuna and mackerel family, Scombridae. This species of mackerel closely resembles the Atlantic chub mackerel. The chub mackerel has a well-developed swim bladder attached with the esophagus, which the true mackerels in the genus Scombra lack, and a characteristic color difference is seen between the chub and the Atlantic chub, the latter being silvery, sighted below the midline, whereas the lower part of the sides of the chub, otherwise colored somewhat like the Atlantic, are mottled with small dusky blotches, and the chub has a larger eye than the Atlantic. Less obvious differences are that the dorsal fins are closer together in the chub and only 9 or 10 spines are in its first dorsal fin instead of 11 or more, which is the usual count in the Atlantic mackerel. In most species, the mackerel is known to travel in large schools. It is a smaller fish than its better-known relatives, growing to a length around 8 to 14 inches, 20 to 36 centimeters. Chub mackerel school like Atlantic mackerel, and their feeding habits are much the same, eating the same species of pelagic crustaceans and sagittae that the mackerel had taken at the same time and place. While specimens taken at Woods Hole ate chiefly copepods, to a lesser extent on amphipods, salps, appendicularians, and young herring. They follow thrown bait as readily and bite quite as greedily as Atlantic mackerel do. Their breeding habits have not been studied. Bull shark, Carcharhinus lucas, also known as the Zambezi shark and formerly Zambi, in Africa and Lake Nicaragua shark in Nicaragua, is a species of requiem shark commonly found worldwide in warm, shallow waters along coasts and in rivers. It is known for its aggressive nature and presence mainly in warm, shallow brackish and freshwater systems including estuaries and lower reaches of rivers. Bull sharks are urohaline and can thrive in both salt and fresh water. They are known to travel far up rivers, and have been known to travel up the Mississippi River as far as Alton, Illinois, about 1,100 kilometers, 700 mi, from the ocean, but few freshwater interactions with humans have been recorded. Larger-sized bull sharks are probably responsible for the majority of nearshore shark attacks, including many incidents of shark bites attributed to other species. Bull sharks are large and stout, with females being larger than males. The bull shark can be up to 81 centimeters, 2 feet, 8 inches, in length at birth. Adult female bull sharks average 2.4 meters, 8 feet long and typically weigh 130 kilograms, 290 lb, whereas the slightly smaller adult male averages 2.25 meters, 7 feet and 95 kilograms, 209 lb. While a maximum size of 3.5 meters, 11 feet is commonly reported, a single record exists of a female specimen of exactly 4.0 meters, 13 feet. Bull sharks are wider and heavier than other requiem sharks of comparable length, and are gray on top and white below. The second dorsal fin is smaller than the first. The bull shark's caudal fin is longer and lower than that of the larger sharks, and it has a small snout, and lacks an interdorsal ridge. The epaulet shark, Hemicilia micellidum, is a species of long-tailed carpet shark, family Hemiciliidae, found in shallow, tropical waters off Australia and New Guinea and possibly elsewhere. The common name of this shark comes from the very large, white-margined black spot behind each pectoral fin, which are reminiscent of military epaulets. A small species usually under 1 meter, 3.3 feet long, the epaulet shark has a slender body with a short head and broad, paddle-shaped paired fins. The caudal peduncle, to which the tail fin is attached, comprises over half the shark's length. Adults are light brown above, with scattered darker spots and indistinct saddles. Epaulet sharks have nocturnal habits and frequent shallow water on coral reefs or in tidal pools. This shark has evolved to cope with the severe nighttime oxygen depletion hypoxia in isolated tidal pools by increasing the blood supply to its brain and selectively shutting down non-essential neural functions. It is capable of surviving complete anoxia for 2 hours without ill effects, and at a much higher temperature than most other hypoxia-tolerant animals. Rather than swim, epaulet sharks often walk by wriggling their bodies and pushing with their paired fins. This species feeds on a wide range of small benthic invertebrates and bony fishes. Epaulet sharks are oviparous, with females depositing pairs of egg capsules around every 14 days from August to December.
The bonnet head, Fanart, also called bonnet shark or shovel head, is a small member of the hammerhead shark genus Swafinia and a part of the family Swafinidae. It is abundant species in the littoral zone of the North Atlantic and the Gulf of Mexico. It's the only shark that species known to display sexual dimorphism in the morphology of the head, and is the only known shark species to be omnivorous. The shark is characterized by a broad, smooth, spade-like head. It has the smallest cephalofoil, or hammerhead, of all the Swafinia species. The body is a gray-brown above and a lighter on the underside. Typically, bonnethead sharks are about 80 to 90 centimeters long, with a maximum size of about 150 centimeters. It frequents shallow estuaries and bays over seagrass, mud, and sandy bottoms. The bonnethead shark is an active tropical shark that swims in small groups of 5 to 15 individuals, although schools of hundreds or even thousands have been reported. They move constantly following changes in the water temperature and to maintain respiration. The shark feeds primarily on crustaceans, consisting mostly of blue crabs, but also shrimp, mollusks, and small fish. Its feeding behavior involves swimming across the seafloor, moving its head in arc-like patterns like a metal detector, looking for minute electromagnetic disturbances produced by crabs and other creatures hiding in the sediment. Bonnetheads also ingest large amounts of seagrass, which has been found to make up around 62% of their gut content mass. The species appear to be omnivorous, the only case of plant feeding in sharks.
The common stingray, Dasyatis pastinaca, is a species of stingray in the family Dasyatidae, found in the northeastern Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean and Black Seas. It typically inhabits sandy or muddy habitats in coastal waters shallower than 60 meters, 200 feet, often burying itself in sediment. Usually measuring 45 centimeters, 18 in across, the common stingray has a diamond-shaped pectoral fin disc slightly wider than long, and a whip-like tail with upper and lower fin folds. It can be identified by its plain coloration and mostly smooth skin, except for a row of tubercles along the midline of the back in the largest individuals. The predominant prey of the common stingray are bottom-dwelling crustaceans, though it also takes mollusks, polychaete worms, and small bony fishes. It is aplacental viviparous. The embryos are nourished by yolk and later histotroph uterine milk, produced by the mother. Females bear 4-9 young twice per year in shallow water, after a gestation period of 4 months. The common stingray can inflict a painful, though rarely life-threatening, wound with its venomous tail spine.
Menhaden, also known as musbunker, bunker, and the most important fish in the sea, are forage fish of the genera Brevoortia and Ephemidium, two genera of marine fish in the family Cupidae. Menhaden are flat and have soft flesh and a deeply forked tail. They rarely exceed 15 inches in length and have a varied weight range. Gulf menhaden and Atlantic menhaden are small, oily-fleshed fish, bright silver in color and characterized by a series of smaller spots behind the main humeral spot. They tend to have larger scales than yellowfin menhaden and fine scale menhaden. In addition, yellowfin menhaden tail rays are a bright yellow in contrast to those of Atlantic menhadens. Menhaden are filter feeders that travel in large, slow-moving, and tightly packed schools with open mouths. Filter feeders typically take into their mouths materials in the same proportions as they occur in ambient waters. Menhaden have two main sources of food, phytoplankton and zooplankton. A menhaden's diet varies considerably over the course of its lifetime and is directly related to its size. The smallest menhaden, typically those under 1 year old, eat primarily phytoplankton. After that age, adult menhaden gradually shift to a diet comprised of almost exclusively zooplankton. Menhaden are a pelagic schooling fish that migrate inshore during the summer and offshore in the winter months. The juvenile and larval menhaden migrate to shore and inland waters through the currents during summer months to grow while feeding on the phytoplankton and eventually zooplankton once they have matured.
The yellow long-nosed butterflyfish or forceps butterflyfish, Forcipiger flavissimus, is a species of marine fish in the family Chaetodontidae. The yellow long-nosed butterflyfish is widespread throughout the tropical waters of the Indo-Pacific area from the eastern coast of Africa to Hawaii, Red Sea included, and is also found in the eastern Pacific Ocean from Baja California to the Revillagigedo Islands and the Galapagos. It is a small fish which grows up to 22 centimeters in length. Being territorial, yellow long-nosed butterflyfish patrol their patches of coral with a monogamous partner. However, instances of overt aggression among F. flavissimus have been observed between territory holders and individuals of the same sex. Chasing is rare, but when it does occur, males chase males and females chase females. Females defend food resources from other females, while males defend territories containing a female from other males. The giant oarfish, Regalicus glasson, is a species of oarfish of the family Regalicidae. It is an Oceanodromous species with a worldwide distribution, excluding polar regions. Other common names include Pacific oarfish, king of herrings, ribbonfish, and streamer fish. R. glasson is the world's longest bony fish. Its shape is ribbon-like, narrow laterally, with a dorsal fin along its entire length, stubby pectoral fins, and long, or shaped pelvic fins, from which its common name is derived. Its coloration is silver and blue with spots of dark pigmentation, and its fins are crimson. The giant oarfish has a worldwide distribution, having been found as far north as 72 degrees N and as far south as 52 degrees S, but is most commonly found in the tropics to middle latitudes. It has been categorized as Oceanodromous, following its primary food source. It is thought to inhabit the sunlit epipelagic to dimly lit mesopelagic zones, ranging as deeply as 1,000 meters, 3,300 feet below the surface. Halosaurs are eel-shaped fishes found only at great ocean depths. As the family Halosauridae, halosaurs are one of two families within the order Nautacanthiformes, the other being the deep-sea spiny eels, Nautacanthidae. Halosaurs are thought to have a worldwide distribution, with some 17 species and 3 genera represented. The largest species, the 90 cm, 3 feet, long abyssal halosaur, Halosauropsis macrochiaer, is also one of the most deep-living fish, recorded at depths of 3,300 meters, 11,000 feet. Halosaurs have developed certain adaptations to life at these extreme depths, where no light penetrates. Their lateral line system enabling the detection of vibrations in the water is highly developed. The pores run the length of the fish's body. Some species are also known to hold their elongated pectorals erect and forward, possibly providing a further means of detection. Halosaurs are benthic fish, spending their time cruising over or resting on the seafloor, where temperatures may be just 2-4 degrees Celsius. They propel themselves with rhythmic, lateral undulations of their bodies, not unlike sea snakes. Halosaurs are thought to prey mainly on benthic invertebrates, such as polychaete worms, echinoderms, and crustaceans such as copepods, but they may also consume small fishes and cephalopods. A salp or salpa is a barrel-shaped, planktic tunicate. It moves by contracting, thereby pumping water through its gelatinous body, one of the most efficient examples of jet propulsion in the animal kingdom. The salp drains the pumped water through its internal feeding filters, feeding on phytoplankton. Salps are common in equatorial, temperate, and cold seas, where they can be seen at the surface, singly or in long, stringy colonies. The most abundant concentrations of salps are in the Southern Ocean near Antarctica, where they sometimes form enormous swarms, often in deep water, and are sometimes even more abundant than krill. Polycarpa orta, also known as the ox heart acidin, the goldmouth sea squirt or the inkspot sea squirt, is a species of tunicate in the family Styellidae. Polycarpa orta grows to a height of 5 to 15 centimeters, 2 to 6 in. It has an urn-shaped, hollow body with two siphons, one at the top and the other on the side. The body color of this tunicate is white with purple and orange patches and purple lines. The inside is yellow or orange and this is visible around the rim of the siphons. This species is found in the tropical eastern Indian Ocean and the western Pacific Ocean. Its range includes the Philippines, Indonesia and northern Australia. Its depth range is 5 to 50 meters, 16 to 164 feet. Tunicates feed by drawing water in through the branchial siphon at the top, filtering out phytoplankton, bacteria and other food particles, before expelling the water through the atrial siphon at the side. Sometimes hydroids and algae grow on the outside of the tunicate and nuded branches such as Nimbropha linealata sometimes feed on it. A planarian is one of many flatworms of the traditional class Turbellaria. It usually describes free-living flatworms of the order Triclatida, triclids, although this common name is also used for a wide number of free-living platyhelminthes. Planaria are common to many parts of the world, living in both saltwater and freshwater ponds and rivers. Some species are terrestrial and are found under logs, in or on the soil, and on plants in humid areas. The triclids are characterized by triply branched intestine and anteriorly situated ovaries, next to the brain. Today the order Triclatida is split into three suborders, according to their phylogenetic relationships, Maricola, Cavernicola and Continenticola. Formerly, the Triclatida was split according to habitats, Maricola, which is marine, Paludicola which inhabits fresh water, and Terricola, which is land-dwelling. Some planarian species have two eye spots, also known as ocelli, that can detect the intensity of light, while others have several eye spots. The eye spots act as photoreceptors and are used to move away from light sources. Planaria have three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm, and are a colimate. They have a very solid body with no body cavity. They have a single opening digestive tract. In Triclatida planarians this consists of one anterior branch and two posterior branches. Planarians move by beating cilia on the ventral dermis, allowing them to glide along on a film of mucus. Some also may move by undulations of the whole body by the contractions of muscles built into the body membrane. Triclids play an important role in watercourse ecosystems and are often very important as bioindicators. Baroidea is a family of ctenophores or comb jellies more commonly referred to as the baroids. It is the only family within the monotypic order Baroidea and the class Nuda. They are distinguished from other comb jellies by the complete absence of tentacles, in both juvenile and adult stages. Species of the family Baroidea are found in all the world's oceans and seas and are free swimmers that form part of the plankton. Aurelia orta, also called the common jellyfish, moon jelly or saucer jelly, is a species of the genus Aurelia. All species in the genus are very similar, and it is difficult to identify Aurelia medusae without genetic sampling. Most of what follows applies equally to all species of the genus. The most common method used to identify the species consists of selecting a jellyfish from a harbor using a device, usually a drinking glass and then photographing the subject. This means that they can be released into the harbor shortly afterwards and return to their natural habitat. The jellyfish is almost entirely translucent, usually about 25-40 cm, 10-16 in diameter, and can be recognized by its four horseshoe-shaped gonads, easily seen through the top of the bell. It feeds by collecting medusae, plankton, and mollusks with its tentacles, and bringing them into its body for digestion. It is capable of only limited motion, and drifts with the current, even when swimming.
The black sea nettle, Kisoata aculos, sometimes informally known as the black jellyfish, is a species of jellyfish that can be found in the waters of the Pacific Ocean. Range is thought to be from the Monterey Bay in the north down to southern Baja California and Mexico, though there are reports of sightings as far north as British Columbia. The initial acknowledgement of the species occurred in 1997 after large groups were found on the Pacific coast. The black sea nettle can be quite massive, with a bell diameter of potentially up to 1 meter, and oral arms extending to 5 or 6 meters. The bell color is a distinctive, opaque, dark purple to nearly black, with the margin having a lighter brown reticulated pattern. No other West Coast jelly that visits shore waters has this dark pigmentation. 4 gonads are attached to the finger-like projections that extend throughout the sub-umbellar openings, the ostia. Marginal sense organs are spaced around the bell margin after every set of 3 tentacles, for a total of 8. An earthworm is a terrestrial invertebrate that belongs to the phylum Annelida. They exhibit a tube within a tube body plan. They are externally segmented with a corresponding internal segmentation, and they usually have setae on all segments. They occur worldwide where soil, water, and temperature allow it. Earthworms are commonly found in soil, eating a wide variety of organic matter. This organic matter includes plant matter, living protozoa, rotifers, nematodes, bacteria, fungi, and other microorganisms. An earthworm's digestive system runs the length of its body. An earthworm respires through its skin. It has a double transport system made of coelomic fluid, the mucus within the fluid-filled coelom, and a simple, closed circulatory system. It has a central and peripheral nervous system. Its central nervous system consists of 2 ganglia above the mouth, one on either side, connected to a nerve running along its length to the motor neurons and sensory cells in each segment. Large numbers of chemoreceptors concentrate near its mouth. Circumferential and longitudinal muscles edging each segment let the worm move. Similar sets of muscles line the gut, and their actions move digesting food towards the worm's anus.
Tubifex, also called the sludge worm, boogie worm, or sewage worm, is a species of tubificid segmented worm which inhabits the sediments of lakes and rivers on several continents. Tubifex probably includes several species, but distinguishing between them is difficult because the reproductive organs, commonly used in species identification, are resorbed after mating, and because the external characteristics of the worm vary with changes in salinity. These worms ingest sediments, selectively digest bacteria, and absorb molecules through their body walls. The worms can survive with little oxygen by waving hemoglobin-rich tail ends to exploit all available oxygen, and can exchange carbon dioxide and oxygen through their thin skins, in a manner similar to frogs. They can also survive in areas heavily polluted with organic matter that almost no other species can endure. By forming a protective cyst and lowering its metabolic rate, T. tubifex can survive drought and food shortage. Encystment may also function in the dispersal of the worm. They usually inhabit the bottom sediments of lakes, rivers, and occasionally sewer lines and outlets. The nematodes or roundworms constitute the phylum Nematoda, also called Nemothelminthes, with plant parasitic nematodes also known as eelworms. They are a diverse animal phylum inhabiting a broad range of environments. Less formally, they are categorized as helminths, but are taxonomically classified along with arthropods, tardigrades and other molting animals in the clade Ectosazoa, and unlike flatworms, have tubular digestive systems with openings at both ends. Like tardigrades, they have a reduced number of Hox genes, but their sister phylum Nematomorpha has kept the ancestral protostome Hox genotype, which shows that the reduction has occurred within the nematode phylum. Hermatis carunculata, the bearded fireworm, is a type of marine bristleworm belonging to the Amphinomidae family, native to the tropical Atlantic Ocean in the Mediterranean Sea. Bearded fireworms are usually 15 cm in average length, but can reach up to 30 cm. At first glance, this fireworm looks like a centipede with its elongated and flattened appearance, multiple segments, white silks, and parapodia and gills located on the side of its body. Its colors are varied and range from greenish, to yellowish, to reddish, grayish through white with a pearly glow. The body consists of 60 to 150 identical segments separated from each other by a thin white line and protected by cuticles. Each segment has a pair of parapodia, a structure for locomotion, clusters of stinging white bristles, and red or orange gills all in bilateral position. The anterior part of the worm can be recognized by small growths, called caruncle, which have the same color of the gills on the first four segments. The mouth is ventral and is located on the second segment. The head is shown on the first segment and includes the eyes and other sensory organs. The bearded fireworm lives throughout the tropical coastal waters of the Atlantic Ocean. On the eastern side they are found from Algeria to Liberia, and on the western side from the southeast coast of the United States to Guyana, including the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean Sea. Nereus is a genus of polychaete worms in the family Nereidae. It comprises many species, most of which are marine. Nereus possess setae and parapodia for locomotion and gas exchange. They may have two types of setae, which are found on the parapodia. Acicular setae provide support. Locomotor setae are for crawling, and are the bristles that are visible on the exterior of the polychaeta. They are cylindrical in shape, found not only in sandy areas, and they are adapted to burrow. They often cling to seagrass, posidonia, or other grass on rocks and sometimes gather in large groups. Nereus worms are commonly known as ragworms or clam worms. The body is long, slender, and dorso-ventrally flattened, reaching a length of 5-30 centimeters. The head consists of two parts, a roughly triangular anterior lobe, the prostomium, and a posterior ring-like portion, the peristomium. The latter bears four pairs of tentacular cirri, dorsally two pairs of eyes, and ventrally a pair of short two-jointed palps. Nereus are osmoconformers. They are dioecious individuals, are male or female, and they release their haploid gametes into the water, a process called spawning. Moreover, upon fertilization and mitotic divisions of the zygote, nereids form a larval stage which is similar to that of mollusks, i.e. a trochophore larva.
Aphrodita is a genus of marine polychaete worms found in the Mediterranean Sea and the eastern and western Atlantic Ocean. Several members of this genus are known as sea mice. The body of the sea mouse is covered in a dense mat of parapodia and setae, aka hair-like structures. Adults generally fall within a size range of 7.5 to 15 centimeters, but some grow to 30 centimeters. The sea mouse has two pairs of feeler-like appendages close to the mouth and does not have eyes. Locomotion is carried out by several small bristly paddle-like appendages. They are hermaphroditic, which means that they have functional reproductive organs of both sexes. The eggs of one individual are fertilized by the sperm of another. That's all for today. Unfortunately, I cannot go on with the video, but there will be a part 2, where we will cover the mollusks and arthropods seated on Swafinia. Until next time, goodbye.